Welcome back. It's Rufus Williams here on the morning show. I like the way you move. What a song for this next conversation. You know, yesterday we had Dr. Susan Smith Jones on, who talked about colons and talked about how we need to take care of them. Well, my next two guests, one a very good friend of mine, and the other I'm meeting, and hopefully I won't have to know it much more than today. But Marquis Miller is on with us, and Marquis has done a number of things and continues to had an episode that we're going to share with you because it's really important. And joining Marquis is Dr. Rajesh Keswani, who is a gastroenterologist, director of quality, and director of endoscopy at Northwestern Medical Digestive Health Center. Good morning, gentlemen, and welcome to VON. How are you both today?
Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Glad to have both of you. Marquis, why don't we begin with you? Tell us how we came to this moment.
So, well, first of all, Rufus, thanks for having me on, and thanks for being the type of friend who is very willing to call attention to these types of topics. I had not a lot of symptoms, but because I was accustomed to getting regular physicals, and of course, because I had about 3 years ago had a prostatectomy, went to get my colonoscopy. And in getting my colonoscopy, it was discovered that I had polyps, and while polyps are relatively common, I was told I had one that was too large to remove through the colonoscopy, so it needed to be scheduled for surgery. And when they did the biopsy, they discovered that it was what they termed as precancerous. And on that basis, it suggested that a speed was the most necessary order of the day, and got a date set up to have surgery, and had surgery and had it removed.
So, Doc, why don't you come in here? Because, you know, so many things are right there, Marquis. And one is that we need to make sure we get our physicals. We need to make sure that we get our annual physicals and they go through whatever the routines are that they go through. And certainly for men, I don't know what happens in women's physicals, but there's one dreaded part of the physical, but it's a very important part, which is to check the prostate and the way in which that's done. But this colonoscopy is also required at certain times and at certain ages. So, Doc, can you talk about that some?
Yeah, I mean, first I want to thank Mr. Miller just for sharing his story, because this is really what I think helps people understand that we shouldn't be dreading these things. We should be dreading what happens if we don't do these types of tests, right? And the colonoscopy is an important part of that health. And I think you're also highlighting that a lot of men don't sort of be seen for routine physicals, and they put this sort of thing off. And this is very important, because we're now recommending colonoscopies begin at age 45. We screen for colon cancer at age 45. And we know many men don't seek care that early often, because they feel well. But these are silent issues that we need to address and be proactive with that routine health screening, as you're mentioning.
So, Doc, why did it go down? Why did we start doing it earlier? Why begin at 45?
It's a great question. We're noticing that colon cancer and colorectal cancer more broadly is developing at an earlier and earlier age. And then in Black Americans specifically, it's always been that it's been more common to have colorectal cancer and has occurred at an earlier age. So now we recommend it as screening for 45 for all people. In the past, we did recommend it for Black Americans at age 45. And so this is something that I think a lot of people don't have on their radar, because 50 was ingrained in our heads for so long. We thought we could wait till we're 50. And unfortunately, some people, when we find out 50, we like to procrastinate. And so we 52, 53, 54. But as you're hearing from Mr. Miller's story, every month, every year we wait could have a big consequence.
So, Marquis, again, thank you. I mean, I think it's really incredible that you are willing to share as widely as you are, because this is important information to have. And getting it first person makes it that much more important. When you have this kind of an issue, do you feel pain? Is there anything that you notice, or does it only come up because of the test that's been done?
You know, Rufus, it didn't come up as a pain or an ailment. I probably had, to your much earlier point about the song leading in, I probably had a regular movement, you know, pretty much like clockwork. I didn't really notice anything beyond perhaps some constipation, which, you know, sometimes comes from being dehydrated. And even though I drank a lot of water, I also am a coffee drinker, and I'm sure that that doesn't really help all that much. But because I had gone to get my my colonoscopy because it was something that I was due to have at my age, and because I had been very cognizant of looking at my numbers and my PSA because of my prostate diagnosis and all the other health factors, what I realized is that I probably could have gotten this done earlier. Of course, you do the first thing. You go to your physician. You get your workup. They tell you we need to get your FIT, which it has something to do with the bacteria that's in your fecal matter. You do that with the color guard, and I'm not saying this as an advertisement for color guard, but color guard is pretty close to being a good indicator. It came back positive, and so that meant, well, yeah, we're going to go get it checked out. And so I was fortunate enough to have a great team at Northwestern who got me through both the colonoscopy, got me through the preparation, which is no walk in the park, and through a successful surgery.
So, Doc, tell us, because this is something that comes as often as it does, what is it that we can do? Certainly, you get to the point of 45, you need to have checkups. And look, all men need to have checkups at 40, annual checkups at 45 years old, including this colonoscopy. All women who know men who are of those ages need to make sure that they have checkups. All men who are at any ages need to start having annual checkups. And all women who know any men of these ages need to make sure that they get their checkups. We just need to do that. But what can we do on the front end to make sure that, or to try and prevent us from having these issues with our colon?
Yeah, a lot of great points here, and I'm going to emphasize what you said again, which is we got to destigmatize this, right, and just say this is a normal part of getting older, and we need to have checkups, and we need to do things like either a colonoscopy or stool-based testing, as was alluded to earlier. What can we do just in terms of our average health? The good part about preventing colon cancer is it's everything your doctor would tell you to do to stay healthy anyway. Exercise is good. You know, eating a healthy diet is important, avoiding high-fat foods, avoiding red meats, things of that sort, avoiding smoking, all the things you do when you go to the doctor. And unfortunately, it's not eat more dessert and you don't get colon cancer. That's not unfortunately what it is. It's all the good healthy habits we should already be having. But again, I can't emphasize enough that we just need to really get everyone screened in whatever mode we can, because that's really our biggest gap. It's not easy to change a lifetime of habits of a Western diet, but we can definitely get everyone around the age of 45 and just really try to advocate for screening for colon cancer, because it's just far too common and it's way too preventable to have anyone suffer from death from colon cancer.
So cancer of any sort is just a bad thing to hear or to learn about. Talk more specifically about colon cancer and what that is and what that does and how that spreads and what the concerns are that you have with colorectal cancer.
Yeah, so colorectal cancer is, as we mentioned, very common, but when it's caught at a very early stage, it's entirely curable with surgery, and there's no need for anything else besides surgery. If it's caught at the stage before it turns into cancer, called a polyp, that can almost always be removed with a colonoscopy. And at Northwestern Medicine, we specialize in removing complex polyps and trying to get these people to avoid the need for surgery. But when it needs surgery, we also have the most expert surgeons to do that. It's really a question of catching it early. When it's more advanced is when we run into the issues of needing some sort of advanced surgeries. It can go to the liver, it can go elsewhere in the body, and you might need chemotherapy or radiation therapy. All sorts of options are there. Our ultimate goal is obviously to prevent death from colon cancer, but it does take a wide variety of physicians depending on the stage of the tumor, and it can go from anywhere from just a colonoscopy to all the way to radiation, chemotherapy, and complex surgery.
So in these cases, are people, if not caught early enough, do you find situations where you have to remove the entire colon from people? Are people walking around without them because this cancer spreads in the way in which it does?
Yeah, and there are obviously times where you need a major surgery where you remove the entire colon or you need an ostomy. I don't consider those the real sad cases. I mean, we're still trying to keep people with us. The real sad cases is when it spreads so far that patients can't basically have terminal illness. And that's really when we put these things off for too long. But, yeah, sometimes there are challenging surgeries that we do. Sometimes we have to remove parts of the liver, have long-term chemotherapy. But patients are living with the diagnosis of colon cancer and getting cured even when it's a little more advanced because of advances in science. But the longer we wait, the more likely we need more invasive testing, more invasive therapy, and the more likely we are to die from colon cancer.
So this is, I need people to really know. Marcus, bringing this story on is really important for all the reasons that the doctor just explained. And it is quite a service that you're doing with sharing your personal story of this, because so often many of these things are kept in the background. And one, you know so many people know you, so just hearing all of this is pretty incredible, but it's really how we hit and make the difference. So thank you again so much for bringing this to us and bringing your doctor on to help us best understand how this is. I need people to know better who you are as well, as being one who's done what you've done, doing what you're doing, and bringing this on. So when we come back after this break, I want to take a moment, and beyond just his colon, I want you all to meet my friend Marquis Miller, who is indeed my friend, even though he's a member of Omega Sci-Fi. We'll talk about that when we come back right after this break.
You're listening to The Morning Show with Rufus Williams on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
We've been through a crazy time with this pandemic, but thank God we made it through.
Now come join the celebration at Festival of Praise. It's Fred Hammond with Hezekiah Walker. It's Praise plus Israel Houghton.
March 19th at the venue inside the Horseshoe Casino.
A night to thank God for all he's done at the 2022 Festival of Praise. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com.
VON TV's Friday night of premieres rolls on during Women's History Month. On March 11th, enjoy the feel-good family drama, Grandma's House, starring Loretta Devine and Wendy Raquel Robinson. Watch a family in crisis seek help and refuge from the one place they can trust, Grandma's House.
I just need you to stay here with your grandmother, okay?
Baby, this too is gonna pass. You're stronger than even you know.
You have got to check yourself loose from this thing.
God is not going to let you fail if you don't let you fail.
Grandma's House is about love, healing, and forgiveness. Enjoy a star-studded cast as they deliver a celebration of the Black family. You'll laugh and cry at Grandma's House. Premiering Friday, March 11th at 7 p.m. on VON TV. Watch it on Roku, Apple TV+, Amazon Fire, or at VON.TV. VON TV's Friday night of premieres is powered by GM.
She's funny. She's witty. She's opinionated.
Do you know how long it was before I figured out you were Robert McKay? Congratulations on your show. I hear nothing but good things about it, really.
Oh, well, thank you. I'm following after in your footsteps.
Well, please don't, because my feet smell.
Say what?
She's Perry Small. Weekdays at 9 a.m. on The Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
This report is brought to you by WhatsApp. No one should read your personal messages. That's why WhatsApp uses end-to-end encryption. It protects whatever you send before, during, and after you send it. So no one, not even WhatsApp, can read your messages. Always message privately. WhatsApp.
WVON, traffic and weather, now.
We begin our update on the Kennedy O'Hare to downtown in hour and three. Inbound between Harlem and Montrose, we have solid traffic. The Eisenhower Wolf to the post office, a 60-minute trip, solid inbound between Mannheim and the Burn Interchange. Right now, if you're on the Stevenson Tri-State 2 DuSable Lakeshore Drive, 49 minutes solid inbound between 1st Avenue and Tedzie. The Dan Ryan 95th to downtown. 25 minutes, 20, I-57, I-80 to the Ryan. Your weather for today, sunny skies and a high of 40 degrees. Overall, a pleasant day, Chicago. Tonight, a low of 29, and tomorrow, a high of 42. It's currently 29 degrees. That was an update on traffic and weather on 1690 WVON.
Now back to the morning show with Rufus Williams on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
Welcome back. We're talking to Dr. Rajesh Keswani, who is a gastroenterologist at Northwestern, and Marquis Miller, who had an issue with his colon that got the doctor involved in his life, and are here. They're both here today to share with us the what happened and how to prevent it. But Marquis, before we went to break, I ask you to share with folks who you are and what it is that you're doing that makes us really critical to your work and why you're sharing it with us.
Well, Rufus, I've had the blessing and the privilege of being a Chicagoan for now 25 years this year, and I am currently the Chief Diversity Officer for the City of Chicago, working in the Office of the Mayor and the Office of Equity and Racial Justice. I've had a very incredible experience in this work, and one of the things that really got me closer to wanting to tell my story, not just to my circle of friends, but to people that I felt I could touch, not just because of the work that I do, but because of the 25 years of relationships that I've built, was the passing of Chadwick Boseman, who, as you know, passed at age 43 after a secret four-year battle with colon cancer. And I just realized that because I'm in a position where I get a chance to engage with a lot of people for my formal work, for my volunteer work as a trustee and a volunteer with nonprofit organizations, I have a chance to tell folks not just about what I do and what some people might ascribe to me as some of importance, but why it's so important to take care of your health so that you can be present for the kinds of things and opportunities that help to make Chicago a great place to live and work. So I just took it upon myself to be available. I told the medical team at Northwestern that whatever they needed me to do, I would be willing to do, especially because of what I knew about black males and black people in particular being struck down by colon cancer. And I must say, primarily because I had a near miss. I did not have colon cancer. They found that my polyp was precancerous. On that basis alone, I felt like I could do this and help people get such an early detection, early diagnosis, early warning that it might also help them catch their condition before it turned cancerous and could create some major issues for them.
So, Doc, let me ask you this, because there are a couple of things that stand out in Marquis's story. And one, Chadwick Boseman, thank you, Marquis, for introducing that connection that everybody can understand. the Black Panther, who died at 43 from this disease after having suffered with it for some time. Now, the age has been reduced to 45 as being the time in which the first screening should happen, but that still would not have saved Chadwick Boseman. So can you talk about why this is so prevalent in black men and why it wouldn't be even an earlier time that these tests should occur?
Yeah, it's obviously an extremely sad story, and it's frustrating because, as you note, even if he had started at the normal age of 45, that wouldn't have been enough. And that's where it's also really important to think about things like your family history and knowing your family history. If you do have a family history of colon cancer or cancers that are associated with colon cancer that you need to be aware of, things like kidney cancer, and prostate cancer, things like that, you may need to get colonoscopy even earlier. So we generally recommend a colonoscopy 10 years before anyone in your family had colon cancer. So if you had a first-degree relative with colon cancer at age 50, you should start at 40 or sometimes even sooner. And so I think it's not just every recommendation fits for everyone. We need to know your family history, and that's why it's important to seek care even earlier so a good doctor can really work through that history with you. There is that genetic component of disease that is really challenging when we see very young people struck down with cancer that you know a routine screening is not going to prevent. All we can do is try to get the recommendations out for the majority of the population and try to really direct people with high-risk syndromes, people with bad family histories, to get care or even earlier.
So when we think about how it disproportionately affects black adults, is there a reason for that?
Yeah, it's a challenging thing to try to tease out what that is, but a lot of it's going to probably be some sort of genetic contribution, right? We all have different predispositions to cancers and diseases based on our histories, and so that's why we do recommend it even more urgently at age 45 for black Americans. It's tough, though, to say what specific factor relates to the earlier diagnosis. And so the key really here is to focus on that healthy living that we talked about, the diet, exercise, and getting care, and do our best to try to catch this early.
Marquis Miller, Dr. Keswani, thank you so much for joining us this morning for such an important conversation. And Marquis, thank you for all that you do and for sharing your personal journey with us this morning.
Thank you, Rufus, for being such a great friend and being a great voice in the morning.
Thank you. Indeed, thanks for listening. And I mean this in every way. Be well, my friend. Be well.
Thank you, sir.